Good morning, children. This is Sharda from Little Heart Publications, and today I am going to teach you fractions, the chapter 4. So fraction is a phenomena which is used to share things or objects. If a chocolate is brought to you, you and your sibling will share it by making it into two parts, and each part is called as half. So according to the number of students or children or people, the things are shared among yourselves. So let us go into deep. Already you have learned some basic things in class 4. Today let us revise them. Fraction, it is a part of a whole. See this apple, it is divided into two parts, and each part is known as half, and it is represented as 1/2. And a fraction has two parts, and those are separated by a line. The number above the line is known as numerator, and the number below the line is known as denominator. And denominator shows the total number of parts that a thing or an object is divided. And numerator is the number of things that is considered is taken as numerator. And let us go into the types of fractions. Types of fractions. Unit fractions. Fractions with one as numerator are known as unit fractions. Example, 1/5, 1/8, 1/3, etc. And like fractions. Fractions that have the same denominators are known as like fractions. For example, 5/6, 2/6, 1/6, 7/6. All these fractions have the same denominator, so they are called as like fractions. Unlike fractions. Fractions with different denominators are called as unlike fractions. For example, 1/4, 5/8, 7/13, etc. Proper fractions. Fractions in which numerator is less than the denominator are known as proper fractions. N less than D. 1/3, 2/5, 3/13, 19/27. In all these fractions, observe that numerator is less than the denominator. That is about proper fractions. Now, let us go with improper fractions. Yeah, let us go with the improper fractions now. Fractions whose numerator is greater than the denominator are known as improper fractions. 5/2, 8/5, and 15/9, n greater than d. And an improper fraction can be converted into a mixed fraction, I'll tell you later. Mixed fraction, it is the combination of a whole number and a proper fraction is known as mixed fraction. 2/1/3, 5/3/7, 1/4/9, etc. 2/1/3, 2. And 1/3 is this. Two 1/3. We are considering out of this only this. So it is 2 1/3. 2 fulls, whole, plus 1/3. That is 2 1/3. Mixed fraction is the combination of a whole number is this. And 1/3 is a proper fraction. Combination of a whole number and a proper fraction. Coming to the equivalent fractions. Fractions which appear to be different, but their value will be same. Such type of fractions are known as equivalent fractions. Fractions whose numerator and denominator are multiplied or divided by the same number, their value does not change. Such type of fractions are known as equivalent fraction. 2/3 is equal to 4/6 is equal to 8/9. So this fraction is multiplied by 2 and it became 4/6. This is multiplied by 2 and it became 8/12. Sorry. 4 2s are 8 and 6 2s are 12. 8/12. So 2/3 equals 4/6 is equal to 8/12. And 9/15 is equal to 3/5. When numerator and denominator are divided by the same number 3, and it has the value is 3/5. So 9/15 equals to 3/5. Both it looks different, but their value is same. Such type of fractions are known as equivalent fractions. Yeah, let us know about the standard form of the fraction. When do you say that the fraction is in standard form? If the numerator and denominator have no common factors other than one, then the fraction is said to be in standard form. That is, it cannot be further cancelled by any other number. Both the numbers have only one as common factor. Both the numerator and the denominator has only one as common factor. 18/15. So when it is divided by 3, it becomes 6, and when it is divided by 15 is divided by 3, it becomes 5. So 6/5 is the standard form. This cannot be further reduced to simplest form because 5 and 6 have no common factors other than 1. Then this is known as standard form of the fraction. And any whole number can be written as a fraction. 3 is equal to 3/1. 5 is equal to 5/1. By putting denominator as 1, any whole number can be written as a fraction. And now let us go with the addition of fractions. Addition of fractions, for like fractions it is very easy. 2/7 plus 6/7. Both are like fractions because their denominator is same, that is 7. Then take the denominator once and add the numerators, that is the sum of like fractions. It's very easy to find out, but never write 8/14. It is wrong. Denominator should be taken as only once, 7, and just add numerators. Never add denominators for the like fractions. And coming to the unlike fractions, we cannot add directly. We cannot add directly. Just we first change them to like fractions and then add. I will show you how. Yes, for example, for adding 3/9 and 6/15. Sum of 3/9 and 6/15, both, we know that both are unlike fractions because their denominators are different. For this, what you need to do is, to make the denominator same, we need to find the LCM of denominators. Why should we take LCM? To make the denominators equal or same, we need to find the LCM of the denominators. So what are the denominators here? 9 and 15. So let us go with the LCM of 9 and 15. 9 and 15 LCM. So for finding out LCM, we should use only prime numbers. 9 and 15, let us, the common factor is 3. It's a prime number. 3 threes are 9. 3 fives are 15. Again with 3. 3 ones are, bring down 5 as it is. And now take 5. 1 as it is and 5 ones are 5. So LCM of 9 and 15 is 3 into 3 into 5, that is 45. Now take the fraction 3/9 and we find out LCM, so that the denominator should be the LCM or the same. So 3/9 is equal to, denominator should be 45. So this 9 is raised to 45. So this numerator should also be raised to 5 times. How did 9 become 45 here? By multiplying by 5. So multiply the numerator 3 also by 5 so that you get 15. And here also 6/15. So the denominator should be the LCM 45. So 15 threes are 45. So denominator is raised 3 times. So raise the numerator also 3 times, that is multiply by 3 as we have multiplied the denominator by 3. So 6 threes are 18. So we have made these unlike fractions into like fractions by making the denominator same. So instead of 3/9, we can write 15/45. See here, 5 threes are, 5 nines are. The value did not change here. So 6/15, it is written as, it can be written as 18 by 45. So as the denominators are same, just add the numerators. 15 plus 18 is 33 by 45. In this way you can add like fractions. Let us go with another problem. 17 by 8 plus 19 by 24. Both are unlike fractions. Find the LCM of 8 and 24 so that we can make the denominators equal or same. So 8 and 24, always use prime numbers to find the LCM. 2 4s are 8, 2 12s are 24, and 2 2s are. 4 is divided by 2 and the answer is 2 here. 12 is divided by 2, the quotient is 6 here. And again 2 and 6. 2 1s are, 2 3s are. 3, bring down 1 and 3 1s are. So the LCM of 8 and 24 is 24. And without finding LCM also, without this process also, you can find out. When smaller number is a factor of the bigger number, then the bigger number will be the automatically the LCM. 8 is a factor of 24, we know. So 24 will be the LCM here. Now, take the fraction 17 by 8. And denominator should be 24, we know, because it is LCM. So 8 is raised 3 times. So raise the numerator also 3 times. 17 3s are 51. 15 1 by 24. Here 9 by 24. Already LCM is the denominator here. So just multiply by 1. 24 1s are, 9 1s are. 15 by 24 plus 9 by 24. As the denominators are same, add the numerators. 51 plus 9 is equal to 60 by 24. This is not in the standard form, so we can divide by 12. 12 5s are, 12 2s are. So 5 by 2 is the standard form of this, and in this way you can find out. Now write the type of fraction. Already I have taught you the type of fractions, types of fractions. Identify which type of fraction it is. 1 by 5, as 1 is the numerator, it is unit fraction. And 2 by 7, here numerator is less than the denominator, so it is proper fraction. And 9 by 16, it is also proper fraction. And 5, 3 by 9, whole number and a combination of proper fraction is mixed fraction. This is mixed fraction. Here, n greater than d, numerator is greater than denominator, so it is improper fraction. So by seeing the fractions, you should be able to identify what type of fraction is it. Now, an improper fraction is given, you have to change it into mixed fraction. The mixed fraction formula is, standard form is QR by D. Now, divide the numerator by the denominator. To change into mixed fraction, it is an improper fraction. We know that 24 is greater than 5. Numerator greater than denominator, so it is improper fraction. Let us change it into mixed fraction. For that, you need to divide the numerator by the denominator. 5 4s are 20. So 24 minus 20 is 4. And the standard form is QR by D. Q is quotient, R is remainder, D is denominator. So QR by D is 4, 4 by 5. 5 4s are 20, 24 by 5. See, 5 4s are 20 plus 4. This is the standard form of the mixed fraction. 43 by 8 again, let us divide. 8543. So Q R D. Q is 5 in the whole number part, and 3 as numerator in the proper fraction, and 8 as denominator. Both the denominator should never change here. So 5 3 by 8 is the mixed fraction for 43 by 8, and vice versa, let us change mixed fraction into improper fraction. So denominator into whole number, denominator into whole number plus numerator by denominator, denominator into whole number, 3 into 5 plus 4 numerator by denominator 5. So 5 3s are 15 plus 4, 19 by 5 is the improper fraction for this. So 7 into 9 plus 2 by 9. 7 9s are 63 plus 2 by 9, that is 65 by 9. In this way you can change improper to mixed, and improper to mixed, and mixed to improper. Now let us find out equivalent fraction. Write two equivalent fractions for 2 by 9, 8 by 15. So how do you get an equivalent fraction? If you multiply the numerator and denominator by the same number, you will get an equivalent fraction with equal value of the given fraction. The value does not change. 2 by 9. So multiply the numerator and denominator by 2. 2 2s are 4, 9 2s are 18. Now again multiply the numerator and the denominator with 5, you will get another equivalent fraction. 2 5s are 10, 9 5s are 45. So equivalent fractions of 2 by 9 are 4 by 18 and 10 by 45. You can multiply with any number, you get an equivalent fraction. Now coming to 8 by 15. Write two equivalent fractions for 8 by 15. 8 by 15, 8 is multiplied by 3 and 15 is multiplied by 3. 8 3s are 24 and 15 3s are 45. 8, and then again multiply 8 by 15 with another number, 10. Both the numerator and denominator should be multiplied by 10. 8 10s are 80, 15 10s are 150. So equivalent fractions of 8 by 15 are 24 by 45, 80 by 150. So for any given fraction, okay, if you multiply the numerator and denominator by the same number, you can get equivalent fractions for the given fraction. Now, standard form of a fraction. So write the following in standard form. 8 by 24. When do you call a fraction is in standard form? If there are no common factors for the numerator and denominator other than 1. See here, 8 by 24. 8 divided by 4. 24 divided by 4. 2. 4 2s are 8. 4 6s are 24. Again, 2 and 6 have common factor. So 2 divided by 2, 6 divided by 2, 1 by 3, or it can be written as 8 by 24 divided by 8, you can directly get 1 by 3. 3 and 1 have no other common factor except 1, so 1 by 3 is the standard form of 8 by 24. It cannot be further divided or cancelled by any number other than 1. 49 by 63. So 49 by 63, there is no other common factor except 7. 49 divided by 7, So 49 by 63. Cancel with 7. 7 sevens are 49. 7 nines are 63. So 7 by 9 is the standard form of 49 by 7. 32 by 40. It can be cancelled or divided by 8. Cancellation is nothing but division. So divided by 8, divided by 8. 8 fours are 32. 8 fives are 40. 4 by 5 is the standard form. So in this way you can change your fraction into standard form by dividing the numerator and the denominator by the same factor. Thank you. And exercises are given in the page number 65. You can complete them basing on these concepts.